Okay, let's discuss for those what became the property. We are going to write the property. We have a number of properties. One is shape. What is that? Shape. First property is shape. Second property is soul. What we can value. And coming to top, third property is rigidity or flexibility. Rigidity or flexibility. And fourth property is compressibility. And fifth property is density. And sixth property is free surfaces. Free surfaces. And seventh one, diffusion. What is that? Diffusion. See here, one talk about solids, liquids, gases, and their properties. We are comparing the whole properties to the states of matter. What you are comparing, these properties, shape, volume, rigidity or flexibility, compressibility, density, and free surfaces, diffusion. Coming to talk for that solid state. I am talking to you, solid state. So for solid state having fixed shape. Solid state are having fixed shape. Okay? And coming to talk about it having fixed value. It having definite value or fixed value. Definite value or fixed value. Rigidity or flexibility. Rigidity or flexibility. See here, the solids are having rigid shape. It's having rigid shape, means fixed shape. It never move at any depth. It never move at any depth. Understand? And coming to talk about compressibility. Compressibility means what? If the space is more between the molecules, means intermolecular space is more between the molecules, then we can say the state of matter consists, compressibility is more. Compressibility is more. Understand? The same way what I'm talking to you. So solids have no space between the molecules. So what we can say, least compressibility. What we can? Least compressibility. Least compressibility for water, solid state. Because it has no least space between molecules. Space between molecules means what we can say, nil intermolecular space. Almost nil. What we can say, almost nil intermolecular space between the molecules of solid state. Coming to talk about next thing is what we can coming to talk compressibility. Compressibility what we discussed, it is the least. And next we are talking about density. What we are talking about density. How the density? How the density? Density for solids having more means solids are having density more. Density more for solids. More for solids. And free surfaces. It having number of free surfaces. It having more number of surfaces. It having number of surfaces means If you consider any one of the solid shapes, suppose this is one surface, this is one, such a like it having number of three surfaces and diffusion. Solids never take diffusion itself. Means what we can say in same type of substance. Are you understand what I'm talking to you? See one thing. What we can talk? Diffusion means the substance which can uniformly distribute throughout the substance. Means suppose take sugar or salt in water. Mix well together salt or sugar in water. After mixing, we may observe after some interval of time the salt or sugar particles may disappear. Means the salt or sugar particles are solid state of particles distributed uniformly throughout the substance. So solid particles are diffused, means dissolved completely in liquid particles. Means solid can diffuse into the liquid. So same as take salt or sugar, both combined together. Is it possible to diffuse each other? No more. So solid cannot diffuse in itself. Means in its term. Coming to talk about what we can for liquid. What we can for liquid. Is that clear to you? For liquid, for shape, it has no fixed shape. No fixed shape means it depends on shape of container. It has its shape. Its shape depends upon shape of container. What is the shape of the container? The liquid will get same as. If you fill any container with liquid, what is the shape? We already discussed. It belongs to the particular. Same as. So next thing is the volume. It has a definite volume. I'm coming to talk another thing. Rigidity or flexibility. Liquids are having flexibility. It's having flexibility. Because it can flow at any surface. Okay? That's why we call those are fluids. Coming to talk, compressibility. It has some space between the molecules of some intermolecular space is there. Means almost something. Some compressibility. Means what we can say here. So it has more compressibility than solids. Because liquids are having less intermolecular space between them than to the solids. That's why they can flow at any surface. That's why it having flexibility and compressibility. Same as compressible to talk for that, it having more than solid. It has compressibility. Of course, compressibility, what have you written now? Yes, of course, compressibility. Some compressibility, flexibility, okay? And density. It has more density. As same as solid. And free surfaces. Its free surface depends on the surface of container. Means it has only one. It has only one free surface. It has only one free surface. Because where you fill in the container,
the first and outer surface only for the.
Suppose
if you take water in this container, where the water filled, this surface only it consists. So only one surface it consists.
Diffusion.
So it has a more diffusion. What we can more
diffusion.
More
diffusion means solids can diffuse into the water, liquid. Liquid can diffuse into the liquid. Gases can diffuse into the liquid. Those can easily spread out into the liquid and the what we can, anything can easily diffuse. So that's why more diffusion to that.
Such a like properties we may discuss for solids and liquids, some other gases also.
So first note down this, we'll discuss an other state of matter which is suitable properties are applicable for that. We can note down that.
finished coming to talk. Same property show talk for gaseous state. Okay, let me discuss for gaseous state. Coming to talk for gaseous state, what are the properties are suitable for gaseous state? So shape, it has no fixed shape. It has no fixed shape. Means we can say it depends on the shape of the container. Its shape depends upon the shape of the container. What we can say, shape of the container. Where we fill in the container, it shows the same shape of the gaseous state. And first thing is value. It has no fixed value. It has no fixed value. So finally, what we can say, it has no fixed shape and no fixed value, means neither fixed shape nor fixed value. There is no fixed shape and value. So one more thing, before we discuss, liquid has no fixed shape but it has a fixed value. Where we fill the container in that liquid needs not a necessary to fill whole of the volume of container. Because suppose if 100 ml of container, if you fill 50 ml of liquid in that, so that liquid never occupy whole volume of the container. Is it? Suppose if you take 1 liter gas cylinder, suppose 5 liter gas cylinder, you fill only 1 liter gas in that cylinder, but the gas can cover whole over the volume of the 5 liter container. Because gases are having high space between them, means intermolecular space between them. By that, they can flow at any surface. And coming to talk, another thing is rigidity or flexibility. It having high flexibility. Because more space between them. Of course, compressibility also high. High or large compressibility. Why? Because it has more space between molecules. Okay, coming to that density, it have very, very less, what we can say, very less density. Very less density, because that's why those can float at any surface. And free surfaces, it has no free surfaces. It has no free surface or has no surface. Diffusion, large diffusion, what we can, large diffusion. It can diffuse at anywhere easily and fast. The rate of diffusion is more for gaseous state than solids and liquids. Understand? Note on that. Next. Yeah, commence talk. These are the properties to understand state of matter. So coming to that, effect of changing temperature on matter. Effect of changing temperature on matter. So what is that meaning? What we can understand from that statement? Effect of changing temperature on matter means generally in inter conversation according to that we know there are the five states of matter, but why we are learning three states of matter? Because of the three states of matter are fixed and permanent. Remain two states of matter are not permanent nor fixed. They cannot change their state to another form, and also it is under the microscopic level state, and also there is no particular structure and particular information about that. Coming to talk, according to five states, solids, liquid, gases remain to plasma states and BIE, Bose-Einstein state matter. So, but these two we are not learning, but three we are learning. According to that, what is we are learning? Effect of changing temperature on matter. While we are giving temperature to the matter, means the states of matter can change. How? The states of matter can change by giving temperature. How that? States of matter can change by giving temperature. Coming to talk, to understand that, take an ice cubes in a container. Take an ice cubes in a container. Ice cubes, what I'm saying to you? Ice cubes. Ice cubes are in solid state. What are in that? Solid state. Solid state of water, of course. If you give heat energy to the ice cubes, the symbol delta is showing, giving heat energy. If you give heat energy to the ice cubes, what we may observe? By giving heat energy to the ice cubes, it changes into liquid state. It changes into liquid state. Water. What I am saying to you? Liquid state. Further giving continuous heat energy. Further giving continuous heat energy. The water will changes into water vapor. Changes into water vapor means in gas state of water. Gas state of water. See here, by giving continuous heat energy, the state of matter is changes from one state to another state. The state of matter is changes to one state to another state. Do you understand? See here what I'm saying to you. By giving continuous heat energy to the state of matter, both are changing from one state to another state. One state to another state. So it affects complete to change the state of the matter, not to change the property of the matter. See, coming to that, this is a retard stand or iron stand. What is this? Iron stand. Okay? Iron stand. This is What we can say? Clam. What we can? Clam. Okay. Okay, this is a transparent one, and these are ice cubes. What happened? Ice cubes replaced. This is a wooden base. What is that? Wooden base. This is wick. What is this? Is wick. This is wick container or fuel container. Fuel container. Okay. And coming to talk, this is a fuel, and this is flame. Source of heat. What is that? Source of heat. What you are giving? Source of heat. This is transparent container. Okay, ice cubes. This is clamps. Iron stand. Wooden base, okay, source of heat. Understand? See once that equipment, what you are doing. So they are giving heat energy to that. They are giving heat energy to that. This is the first setup, what I'm saying. This is first setup. Ice cubes in solid state. By giving heat energy, what happens? It starts to melt. What we can consider? It starts to melt ice cubes and water. Ice cubes and water. It starts to melting. Start to melting. Further giving heat energy, what happens? The total solid state of water or ice cubes are converting into water. Converting into water. After melt. After melt. See that? What I'm saying? Further giving continuous heat energy, the solid state is converting into the liquid state. So by giving heat energy to the matter, it changed its state from one state to another. Further giving continuous heat energy, what happens? The water starts to boil. The water start to boil. Means it is boiling at inside. Imagine when you lift a pan from the cooking rice. We may observe while it's cooking, the water droplet means food, cooking food are floating up and down. Okay? Same as to talk for the fifth condition. Further giving continuous heat energy, the water starts to form into the water vapor. Okay? If you further continuous giving heat energy, water can, the whole water will convert into the water vapor. After complete boil, complete evaporate. No more water present at inside. It will complete change into the water vapor. Means the liquid state is changed into the gaseous state. The liquid state is changed into the gaseous state by giving temperature. See one thing, what I'm saying, by giving temperature to the substance, what happens? It's changing its state. Changing its state. Understand? Coming to talk, what? How to determine whether temperature is rising? By using a, what we can? Laboratory thermometer. By using a laboratory thermometer. Laboratory thermometer. Okay, this is a pan covered with. Suppose what I'm saying, if there is no pan, because we have to observe no those. Yes. What we observe? By giving temperature continuously, the mercury level will increase its level. So while it changes to state continuously from liquid, solid to liquid, liquid to gases, so what happens? The mercury level will rise to upwards. Understand? By raising the mercury level in the thermometer, by raising the thermometric liquid level, we may observe what happens. The temperature is rises, and also what happens? We are observing the change of the state. The change of the state. Imagine, if you done this activity in a closed chamber, after changing complete water into the water vapor, if you decrease the temperature to the water vapor, first it came to solid to water, means solid to liquid, liquid to water, means gases. If you decrease the temperature to the water vapor, it change into the, what happened, liquid state. Means the gaseous state is converted into liquid state by decreasing the temperature. Before, what happened, the temperature is receiving and changing its state by breaking the bond between molecules. Means by breaking the force between the molecules, it increases the space between the molecules and it changes to one state to another state. Understand? Same as by decreasing temperature to the water vapor, means gaseous state, it converts into the liquid state. Further, if it decreases the temperature to the liquid state, what happens? It converts into the solid state. Let me take same example. If we decrease the temperature to the water vapor, suppose you may observe during the winter morning, what happens? The water droplets are forming on open atmosphere in the plains, window panes, glass, grass. Okay, is it or not? And also, if you take water bottles from the deep refrigerator to the open atmosphere, we may observe after some interval of time, there are some water droplets formed at open at outer surface of the water bottle. That is nothing as a dew forming. So, by decreasing the temperature, what happened? Water vapor converting to the water. And if you place water bottle which is filled with water into the deep refrigerator, after some interval of time, if you look out, what happened? The water converting to the solid, means ice. So, what happened? Solids are changing to liquid state. Liquid states are changing to the gaseous state. Gaseous state again changing to the liquid state. Liquid state again changing to the solid state. By temperature, what happened? The temperature changing the state. Temperature changing the state shows an effect on its state of matter. When state of matter changes, the state of matter changes during the change of temperature. By increasing the temperature, it changes from solid to liquid, liquid to gaseous. By decreasing the temperature, the gaseous state converting into the liquid state is converting into the solid state. Then, which process is involved in this system? Which process to change from solid to liquid, liquid to gases to liquid, liquid to solid? If solid is directly converted to the gases is directly converted to solid, which process are involved? See one thing, camphor, carpura. If you place in open atmosphere, it may directly convert into the gaseous state without leaving liquid. Naphthalene balls. which we are using in our homes to avoid the insect and bat smell in our floors, in our toilets to avoid the bat smell. Those are directly converted to the gas wasted by leaving, by giving fragments to the overall. Then what are the processes? What is the methods are involved in that? That we will talk in the next class. Okay? See you in the next class. Have a good day to you. Keep practice to the lesson, Nature of Matter for online test. See you in the next class. Have a good day to you.